This was what? The Temple of Nefertum. It's a final new area. We haven't explored it. And we're lacking two canopy jars, and we have a scarab of time. Where are they? I've seen better days. This is actually one of the more clever places in this game. It's a time traveling part. This is the current temple, and then you travel backwards in time to old temple when it was in perfect condition. So this ruin is actually shows you a few tips and where what you can do when you arrive at the intact temple. For example, this corridor will be sort of cut off from here and in perfect condition. So unless you notice this place at when you in the current time temple, it's hard to realize that there's a hidden passage here or a non-collapsed version of this passage. So it's supposed to keep your eyes open here. You find anything at all interesting, take note of it. You probably won't at the first time, because there's no way to know what you really need to do here. More likely you won't find everything at the first try in the past, and then you will come back here. And then you notice things that don't really match up perfectly what you saw in inaccurate. You oh, there a green mana here. No, more armor. And not torch. I'd be using torches much. Frankly, the light radius they give out is too small. Something like this. You know, this is almost useless and they don't last long, so what's the goddamn point of using these? Maybe if you had melee your main attack even at this point, then sure. This does give a good attack boost. Single strike killed an archer. Yeah, this is Staff of Nefertum to use this. We can only use the one in the past at the moment, and to gain their access we need to use the Scarab of Time. Yeah. This wall tells of Sith searching for his Scarab of Time. The ancient Temple of Nefertum. You have found the time portal to Sith. You have traveled back 1,000 years to the temple. Okay, we have so many tomes of power we can powers we can pick up new ones. Here, well, you can spot this if you look close enough, but it's obvious if you paid attention to this general structure in the future. More armor class, more mana. Ah, that was good. Okay, what's this? Is anything? Kind of a big jar. That can't be the only reason why we came here. Hey, there's another place. Shrine of... I can't see from here. Shrine of something, let's go there now. How do we open that? Nothing here. Oh shit! That was bad. That was very, very, very bad. Didn't mean to drop down there. That's a little bit better. There's an item. One seems to be a key, one is a part of the staff, one is a full mana item. Rameses foretells of the Rameses the second, or yes, foretells of the Wheel of Ages being aligned on both equinoxes at the same yet different times. So just in case you don't really really know what to do, there are these tips spread around all over. Nothing special, just trying to keep my eyes open. Yeah. It's the guardian key. I have no idea where you should use a guardian key. But now we have it. We need when we need it. Let's go here. I have one more item we can use. Definitely need Kenobi jars. Okay, I might be able to remember that. I did make a marking of it at some point, but it was in the previous game, and I'm just gonna don't recall where the actual notes are. We need a. Two more of these Kenobi jar. I think one more, this one will be sufficient from this place. Yeah, because I seem to recall one of them being the Eye of the Serpent. That's where you get one of them. A rough cut game. Magic. How many do we have of those? Over 10. Yeah, we don't have to worry about running out of magic anytime soon. Thank you. do I need to I was trying to recall what the quick key for mana restoration item was. I usually have some kind of odd naming convention for them, at least in my own mind. Just have to refresh my memory. Prophecy of Amun. Within the wheel of the ages, to alignment with each equinox, shall upper and lower Egypt unite. And we definitely need to start using those tomes of power. We'll set this to Hippopotamus. This is likely the exit. Another full mana. But we can't leave here now, there was a can of HR here. We do need to get it for XP. And we need to rock a gem too. I'm not quite sure if the rough cut gem is here. Ah, yes it is. It is how I recall this. Rough cut gem? And the cannabis jar. Okay, we've got everything. So how did it go? Sequence hook? Full, now we can go. No, we don't want to come here. We need to get back to our own time. We need to go there to achieve it. Yeah, we started here. Right from here. Got a little bit of a loss there, but not too badly. More importantly, we have three canopic jars and the rough cut diamond or gem. Now we just have to recall where do we need to take it. It's not here. It's in the... I think it's in the Temple of Anubis. It's not in the Palace of the Pharaoh. Yeah, Pyramid of Anubis. Yeah, I think this is it. This is indeed. And we need to cut it. Serpent's Eye Gem. I know this snake will come up to life. Not sure how close we need to go. This weapon was very ineffectual. And the last kind of picture. That's just a teleporter up here if you fall down. There. I think we need to go where the Pharaoh's pyramid is. Did you? No. We need the crown of Lower Egypt, and that's what we can get here. We can also gain access to the, or free up the Staff of Nefertum here. That will allow us to change the constellation wheel in our own time, which allows us to get the upper crown of Egypt. Crap, it's those imps again. And we have an access to a new area, which should allow us to... I think that's an exit. What is this? Temple of Light. Yeah, we should now be able to secure access to all the remaining closed areas. We need the crown from here, and then we need to alter a clock sundial. We should use the power portal here. You need the key of Ra. Well, we certainly don't have the key of Ra, so jump, I guess. study through magic, like something. Get up. So what do we need to do here? Ah, need to pull that switch. Kira. Another false door. False wall, more precisely. Bad. Almost killed myself. Now we need to turn the clock to 12 o'clock. So slow. When the Ra, meaning the sun, rides his chariot the highest, that's noon. Now the door should be open. That allows us to gain access to the staff of Midburgum. Hey, you have here a door open above you. Yeah, I did wonder. It is. Might as well use the tome and take this with us. Oh no, there was a teleporter here. Okay, now we should have access to this staff of Ra. No, definitely not there. Yeah. Very easy to get lost. Not that kind of a maze, but it's large enough that you can lose your heading. We have done. We need Temple of Nefertum. No. No. We need to get the staff of Nefertum. Otherwise, this is all just a waste of time. I don't exactly recall where it is, but I... somewhere at the end of this... of this side of the dungeon. We'll retrace our steps until we find it. Yeah, here it is. Staff of the Fair. Yeah, this is exactly where we need to go. This is the Temple of Nefertum. Yep. We just need to spin the constellation wheel, and that should be it. That's the end of this episode. After naturally killing Famine, isn't exactly a fun job. We'll continue pushing the button until something happens. At this point, the enemies we'll face will start to be somewhat of a pain in the ass. I don't recall what it's like to fight against him. One way to find out, I guess. Let's see. Very, very powerful. As the killing blow falls, Pestilence is enveloped in a cloud of energy, forever removing the blight of his scabrous body from the face of Therion. Once again, there is a sickening twist, and you find yourself in the land of Septimus, Therion's final defense against the coming of Eidolon. In a sick sort of irony, it seems fitting that the Dark General known as War would rule the most militaristic civilization in the world. Taking a few minutes of much needed rest, you reflect on what you have accomplished. You wonder to yourself, what sort of powerful being could bend the Dark General's will? Are you intent on crashing on me? Apparently it is.